Brazil's unique killer, Pedrinho Matador, or Killer Petey, is notorious for killing roughly 100 other criminals, including his own father, and then becoming a famous YouTuber. On the 17th of July, 1954, Pedro Rodrigues Filho was delivered into the world with a damaged skull due to a beating his mother received by his father while she was pregnant. Throughout his childhood, he witnessed how his father abused his mother, his siblings, as well as having to endure the beatings himself. Pedro Filho grew up as a farm boy helping around the house. One day in 1967, he had a heated argument with an older cousin and pushed him into a sugarcane press with the intent to kill him. Pedro was hoping his cousin's body would go through the machine the way hard sugarcane did. In 1968, Pedro's father had been fired by the town's vice mayor from his school security job after allegedly stealing food from the school. 14-year-old Pedro felt he needed to take justice into his own hands by using his grandfather's shotgun to kill the mayor in front of City Hall. Not long after, Pedro used the same shotgun to kill a security guard that he had suspected was the real food thief. Afterwards, Pedro fled to Mogi das Cruzes, Greater Sao Paulo in South Brazil. Around the age of 16, Pedro fell in love with Maria Aparecida Olimpia, nicknamed Botina. Once they began living together, their happiness didn't last long. A rival gang made an attack on Pedro, killing his pregnant girlfriend, which beyond infuriated Pedro. This launched him into a crime spree, tracking down, torturing, and killing individuals connected to Botina's murder, all to find the one who took her life. Once Pedro found out it had been the rival gang's leader himself, Pedro gathered a few other guys to help him commit a massacre at a wedding the gang leader had organized, leaving 16 guests injured and brutally murdering 7 others. On the 24th of May, 1973, Pedro was finally apprehended. On the way to the precinct, he shared the police vehicle with 2 other criminals that had also been detained that same night. Once they arrived to the police station, the officer opened the car door to discover the criminal who had been detained for sexually abusing someone had been murdered by Pedro. While in prison, Pedro received news his father had murdered and dismembered his mother with a machete after being informed she was allegedly being unfaithful to him. Pedro knew in his heart someone had been slandering his mother's name and thought of her as the holiest woman in Brazil. He swore in front of his mother's coffin he would avenge her death. Pedrinho Matador arranged a well-thought-out plan to visit his father's holding cell, and as soon as Pedrinho saw an opportunity, he stabbed his father with a machete about 22 times, tore his heart out, sliced the tip off the heart, and proceeded to chew the piece before spitting it at his father's corpse, keeping the promise made to his mother on the day of her funeral.
Eu falei no caixão da minha mãe que eu fui no necrotério ver minha mãe. O juiz autorizou, e o necrotério ficava da frente da cadeia. Aí eu fui, entendeu? Com o gemado, aí eu jurei. Vingança no caixão da minha mãe.
É aquela história do coração, né?
Que é assim. Mas eu só masquei. Que eu cortei o bico do coração, masquei porque eu falei no caixão, vou comer o coração dele. Foi o que eu fiz, foi vingança, mas não que eu engoli. Eu masquei e joguei em cima do corpo do meu pai dentro da cela.
While incarcerated, Pedrinho Matador was highly unlike due to his choice of victims. He murdered 47 confirmed prisoners, his cellmate for disrespecting him, others in self-defense. However, majority of his victims were due to fitting a certain code of ethics that made Pedro feel deserved retribution, such as kingpins, con artists, and sexual abusers. Pedrinho Matador decided to advertise and tattoo on his left forearm, "I kill for pleasure." Initially, when Pedro was arrested, his sentence given was 128 years. After he committed numerous prison murders, his sentence got increased to about 400 years. However, at the time Brazilian law stated the max sentence a person could serve was 30 years, which was later revised in 2019 and increased to 40 years. On the 24th of April 2007, the court ruled Pedro had rehabilitated, releasing him from prison. However, Pedro didn't get to enjoy his freedom for too long. On the 15th of September 2011, Pedro got arrested near the Santa Catarina coast under the charges of false imprisonment and incitement of riot, for which he was sentenced to 7 years in prison and placed in the penal colony of Mongagua. Pedro Rodrigues Filho was finally released in 2018. Since then, the notorious serial killer has been interviewed, invited on podcasts, and even created his own YouTube channel, voicing his thoughts and giving advice to young people. During an interview, it was mentioned Pedro would get the thrill and joy out of killing other criminals, with his favorite method of murder being either stabbing and/or hacking them to death with blades. He would get motivated to act once he'd hear the crime the individual had committed, He would look up the individual's name and address, and once captured, he would sometimes torture the individual to death, either by thrill or anger. Pedro also stated, "The day I didn't kill people, I didn't sleep." Pedro Rodrigues Filho was stated to be the perfect psychopath. Since then, Pedro has turned a new leaf and has converted to Christianity. He mentioned feeling no remorse for the murders, but regrets having entered the crime. When Pedro was asked during a podcast if he'd kill again, he responded, "No, I would only kill again if someone came to take my life or the lives of people I love."